So this isn't a video I thought I'd make. And the first thing I want to make clear is that this is not an attack video against any commenters in any section of any videos. My intention is not to blindly bash anybody I don't know that's probably hundreds of miles away. This is something I want to get off my chest because it's something I noticed not only in my comment section, but the comment section of practically any content creator who dabbles in theorizing any shows, video games, or movies, takes issue with a plot point in said show, game, or movie, or just generally criticizing it and receiving backlash. I've noticed a pattern that's pretty disheartening. In the case of this channel and my friends that I mentioned, when it comes to Steven Universe, Star, any show that we're really into and we're passionate about, anytime a plot point comes up that we disagree with and we give our perspective, our points, our merit, and the exact same energy, if not a little bit more than we would any other video, the comments tend to receive an influx of, oh, you're just mad your theory's wrong. You're just mad the show didn't go in the direction you wanted. Don't you think you're overreacting? Why are you so angry? So on and so forth. What makes it so saddening is that it's pretty obvious that the tables were turned, and in another world where I was excited with a plot twist in the show instead of disagreeing with it, that I was amped, I was pumped, I was excited, I was just over the moon, and still put the exact same amount of energy into it, those comments questioning my reaction would vanish. Lord knows I rarely see a "why are you so happy" comment whenever I'm pumped to see what happens next, which 9 out of 10 times, that's me to a T. But anyways, the notion that I or anyone else would be upset at a plot point because our theory didn't come true almost comes across as if we're being devalued, as if we're only in this just so we can be right about something. In this instance, the reveal in Steven Universe that Rose Quartz is Pink Diamond. When you apply that comment that we only dislike this plot point because we were wrong, take a moment to really search through our content. Not just me, but when you look at both Slice and Mark's channels, you'll discover that we've all made a plethora of theories on what could have happened to Pink Diamond, on who Pink Diamond was. And in the actual reveal of the episode, components of previous theories of mine were in play. And it's not if like I never considered Rose being Pink Diamond. In my upload for that day prior to the episode airing, I even said, I'm coming to accept that Rose is Pink Diamond. I wouldn't like it, but I would accept it, which I did. Now, having a negative reaction to something occurring that you don't want to happen sounds like a pretty human response. But considering the nature of our content, let's ignore that and focus on another aspect. The reason why I like making theories, and as a friend to both Slice and Mark, I know the reason why they make theories, really, any of the Famethysts makes theories, is because it's fun. It challenges us, it causes us to think, rattle our brains, and we go in knowing there's so many solutions, that there's multiple outcomes, and we just want to explore the fun ones, the ones we would like to see happen, but that doesn't mean we won't accept anything else. And, at least for me, most of the time, when a theory of mine is wrong, I tend to favor the canon outcome anyways. And this just doesn't apply to Steven Universe, but Star vs. the Forces of Evil, Rick and Morty, Gravity Falls, shows I theorized before I was even on this channel. And these devaluing comments also leads into my next point. These statements are often accompanied by, "it's just a kid show," which, by proxy, devalues Steven Universe or whatever the cartoon may be that's being discussed. Which is crazy because any other time, a show that's probably being theorized and is on a children's network is praised for being profound or dark or revolutionary. That most people are like, oh, this isn't a kid's show, look at how many dark moments it has, how mature it is. But the second it's being criticized, it's chill out, man. It's just a kid's show. Now, I understand some people do watch these shows, whether if it's for kids or adults, for entertainment. TV to you is entertainment. Theories to you is just entertainment. Not everyone is going to have the same emotional investment towards a property, and that's a-okay. So people who just see these as things to pass the time, who truly feel, hey, people are just way too invested in the show, not just the content creators, but other people, and it truly is just a television show, just a cartoon. Well, that's your opinion, and I can't fault you for that. But just from the impression I see, again, again, in multiple content creator comment sections, it typically comes from people who do acknowledge that these cartoons we celebrate are capable of deep, mature storytelling and shouldn't just be relegated and written off as a kid's show, because more than likely, in the scenario they try to share the show with someone, and that person they think would enjoy the show just wrote it off as a kid's show, as just a cartoon, that it can't hold that much value, would probably greatly offend the person that does like it, that is emotionally invested into it. But let's go back again into the overreacting part. Listen, I understand when you only have audio, you can't see the person's facial features. In the case of my channel, or Slice's channel, and when he uses the avatar, Mark's channel, you can only really infer their emotions by their voice and not their facial expressions, as they're not available. The only thing they have is a correlating avatar, which can, and more often than not, does limit the emotion they're trying to emulate. But just because I'm passionate about something, and my voice is putting energy into it, I get excited, at least from my perspective, doesn't necessarily mean I'm overreacting. If I were to say, oh my god, Rose being Pink Diamond was the best plot twist on the show, and I made a 15 minute video praising why I liked it, why I'm happy about it, and why this is good for the show, and carried that excited, loud, passionate tone in my voice, I feel as if the comments would return that energy. But since it's on the other side, as I am pretty much saying I feel as if this is one of the worst plot twists in the show, but I still present that same energy that I would if I was excited about it, suddenly it becomes an overreaction, as if I'm being too hostile. But I just see that as me being passionate about the show, as I'm sure most content creators are. And another thing is, I can't say I'm mad at the show. I'm invested into these characters, and I clearly want to see where the plot's going to go, even if I do have a good idea on how it's all going to end. If anything, from my perspective, the perspective of the content creator, the one who made the video, I see my rant discussion video on Rose being Pink Diamond as me being frustrated with the character. It's not me damning the show to hell. In fact, I say in the video, don't harass the Crooniverse, this is the story they wanted to tell. We have to respect that, and that this divisiveness, the fact that some people hate this and some people love this, was more than likely intended on their part, I feel at least shows that I have some rationality in me. Now, that video was off script, and again, I was excited. I'm an over-the-top person. It doesn't mean I'm foaming at the mouth, that I'm super mad at the show, that I'm furious with the Crooniverse. No, my perception of a character just changed. A character that I was invested in, a character that I know means a lot to fans. And yeah, this character may not be real, but heart and soul was still put into the character. And I feel as if with all content creators who really look into these theories, who watches the show carefully, who really tries to understand these characters, you do feel a connection with them, a bond with them. So when the character commits some not so great deeds, you're entitled to feel frustrated with them. Again, if I came off as angry, as absolutely fierce, like I was just going to a blind rage, I do apologize and I do understand. As I said, you really only have the audio to go off of. It's a lot hard to pick out, okay, this is just theatrics and this is him actually being serious. But, and again, this goes for all content creators, to just dismiss their points as a tantrum or childish, or they're just mad their theory wasn't right, when we all make a point that, yeah, this is our opinion. Yeah, this doesn't mean anybody who wrote the show is at fault. This is just how we feel. Again, it's just a meaning. And something I want to make crucially clear is that I am not mad or recording this video. I'm actually pretty calm, just like how I wasn't mad in that other video. And to give you guys an idea, usually at all times during work hours for the Roundtable, I'm in close proximity of four other people who hears when I record, who, when I do get loud, they usually say, man, you were loud down there. And usually my editor Josh, who edits some of the Crystal Clears, or who edits other videos for Shane, and sometimes Tom, I usually give them the audio so I can work on a script or research or take care of some business stuff and knock that out of the way while the video is still being worked on and still speeds up the process. And usually when he edits audio, he'll point out something like, oh wow, this made me laugh, or wow, oh, this actually sounds kind of emotional. Josh did not make a single comment like that while editing the Pink Diamond video. And considering he's someone who usually does point out when I am legitimately overreacting, as he's someone that sees me every day, spends time with me every day, and handles the audio portion for a lot of my videos, I don't feel crazy for feeling this way. Again, this is just my perspective, but it really feels as if when content creators dislike something and we're told that we're just mad our theory was wrong, that we're overreacting, it comes across as, you should like this plot. You shouldn't have any issues with this. You're wrong for not liking it. And again, the emotion in my voice, the emotion in Slice's voice, as I know Slice can get very powerful with his videos, the emotion and passion he puts in his videos, like, truly moves me 9 out of 10 times. And even with Mark, someone who cracks a lot of jokes in his videos, I do understand how it could come up as if we're forcing our opinions, but that's legitimately not the case. We're just expressing our thoughts and our criticisms. If we didn't care about the show, if we didn't like it, we wouldn't criticize it and wish for better. The plot twist already happened. Our content on it already happened. And while this video by no means takes back anything I said in those videos, I do hope this does clear things up, not just for me, but other content creators, because I know a majority of them feel this way because I talked to them. But just like how it may be hard for any viewer to possibly pick up the tone of our voice or if we're actually being serious or not, I know it's also difficult for us or anyone on the internet in general to tell the true emotion of someone's voices over text. Is it sarcasm or are they being serious? Nobody knows. It's over text. Guys, I just want to get to a point, and I know it may be impossible, but a point where content creators can express their opinions, the commenters can express their opinions, and we respect those opinions even though we disagree. And I know that requires effort on my end as well. And that's just focusing on my content alone. It's one of those cases where a few negative comments can get to you. The last thing I ever want to do is fake my emotions to please someone, especially in my content. Guys, if I genuinely disagree with a plot point, that's likely not going to change. But it shouldn't. I don't think the show is ruined. And while I am frustrated, as the show goes on, my opinion may change. May. In this case, it's very slim, but we'll see. And this is the part where I usually ask you what you think. So please, if you made it this far, genuinely let all of us know what you think. And shout out to my awesome Patreon supporters who support the Roundtable through thick and thin. As always, if you enjoy this discussion, my take on things, hearing a kind of creative perspective, throw it a like, maybe even share it. And if this is your first Roundtable video, I'm so sorry, but consider hitting that subscribe button and hit the bell for notifications so you don't miss a video. Thank you for watching, and I hope you have a beautiful day. Ostrich Vox, out.